Here in the beautiful Amsterdam at the Rai, and we meet interesting people like Vincent Evers. He's organizing the Blockchain Innovation Conference. How are you doing, Vincent?
Well, Money 2020 is always exciting, and blockchain is a very important track here. So I'm really interested what they're going to see. But of course, I'm also very busy with this coming Friday, where we organize the 6th Blockchain Innovation Conference at ABN AMRO HQ, the headquarters of HQ of ABN AMRO. And yeah, I have 40 speakers. And this year, in 1 year, we really went to production cases. We really went to a lot of places where people use blockchain for good, for a good reason. Mm-hmm. And not only for good, although we have a lot of that too, but for also, for example, oil, Brent oil is now being traded on the blockchain. You know, so Esso and Shell and BP and with a lot of companies, they are basically trading blockchain and settling them on the blockchain. So that is very exciting. And also in Europe, every car will get a digital passport. So the car has an identity, and then of course the owner can basically be added to that. The maintenance can be added to it. The OEM of course has something, and then everything which has to do with that car can be done with that digital identification, that particular passport. And that is not by a particular country, it's not by an OEM, that's a system in general for all the cars. So that's also a very practical use. And then blockchain for good is really interesting. The UNNCR, if they have identified somebody, you know, even without a passport, says you get 200 euros a month, and instead of getting money, they get a wallet. It's filled every month, and if you want to buy things, they go to the supermarket, identify themselves with the iris scan, and basically pay for it. So they cannot be stolen and manipulated anymore. So we have a lot of those kinds of cases where you really see things, billions of dollars being traded on the blockchain.
So blockchain is hot. I mean, all these business cases coming in into these industries, no plans, no proof of concept, but real business.
Real money, real companies working together, and not only a blockchain for a big company who wants to basically optimize their efficiency, but basically competitors working together. So that's one thing. And actually, the second feature next to blockchain and production is, how do you form these alliances? How do you have those competitors work together? How do you set up a blockchain which organizes a market where lots of people have involvement and have interest? So that is the second part we're talking about. Okay. And then the third part, we're going to talk about the future. We have a fantastic speaker who is on the board of the e-commerce committee in China, and 70% of the blockchain projects are currently in China. You know, huge, we have 400 banks which are now trading on the blockchain and settling everything on the blockchain, so like Swift. And he's going to talk about, why is China so totally into blockchain? And then, of course, we have Dave Birch, and he's going to talk about blockchain, big data, and AI, and what is that combination going to do? You know, last year he talked about the tokenization of the industry, which really is happening. We have everywhere, we have tokens which are approved, you know, like bonds, approved by the legislator. Of course, we have the Dutch Central Bank, and we have the AFM there.
Bitbond
is one of the companies who is basically has a loan on the blockchain and is approved by the German regulator. So that is, we have 40 speakers a whole day for the people who do not exactly know what blockchain is. We have a blockchain for dummies, I think from 8 to 9 o'clock, and then you know everything there is that you can follow the discussions.
Workshops.
Yeah, and at the end, there's the end of the blockchain week, because this week is blockchain week, and everybody's going to get together at ABN AMRO from 4 o'clock. Then everybody can come to the two keynote speaks from Dave Birch and the Chinese professor. Cool. And then we have a big reception and celebrate the end of the week of the blockchain. So that's going to happen on June the 7th. So, are you going to be there?
Yeah, I will be there, of course. And so there will be lots of insights, lots of business insights, blockchain insights, and lots of networking going on.
Yeah. I mean, there's people from the healthcare industry, from the real estate economy, they're from the oil, energy, from the financial industry. You know, decentralized finance is really also at Money 2020. It's a big thing here. So we have also lots of examples of what all the banks are doing. And it's really, we have a beautiful project. You know, Rabobank, they do a KYC for personnel, so that you have a CV on the blockchain. And ABN AMRO has huge amount of cases, you know, like the oil on the blockchain. They're very involved in that. So an ING has something. So we have a lot of different things which we're going to show there in the financial industry. So it's going to be lots of fun.
Will the blockchain technology as such also be challenged? Will there be some critical questions about this new technology?
Well, for me, always is the question, is it a private blockchain or a public blockchain? I'm waiting for those public blockchains to be fast, to be secure, to not ruin the earth with energy. You know, so I mean, we have a huge FOMA about blockchain, about Bitcoin at the moment. You know, it's the best performing asset in 2019 by far.
It's a secure network.
It is a secure, Bitcoin has a solid security, but it's unbelievable, you know, in terms of waste, in terms of energy. But I mean, it's really going up, and a lot of other ones. Ethereum is going up again. So that part of the public blockchains and the coins which are there. Of course, we're going to talk about Microsoft, who's going to do identity on the blockchain. Of course, we're going to talk about Facebook, who's starting their own coin, you know, done by the ex-CEO of PayPal. Yeah. Really interesting. So there's a lot of new things coming up, both in the general blockchain, the corporate blockchains, and all the public blockchains.
All right. And what's your personal expectation of the Bitcoin price? Because you're also known of the Bitcoin update with the Telegraaf, of course.
Yeah, well, that is always it's really, I mean, I do not know why. I mean, we have this year Lightning. Lightning is coming to slowly coming to the market, so that you can really do a little bit more transactions on the Bitcoin and the lower cost transactions. I'm waiting for the thing to be used. I'm waiting for Ethereum to be used in the public space. I'm waiting for Bitcoin to be used and then to really do useful things, and then I think the demand will go up. At the moment, it is, you know, there's money coming in from the from family offices at the moment. There's money coming in slowly from the brokers. You know, slowly these connections are being made, but a little bit of demand already goes up, and people are excited about the fact that the mining reward goes down, so less bitcoins will come to the table. But I still want to have usage of Bitcoin, and that's what I'm waiting for before we go again to the big steps forward.
All right. So if people are interested in this great event in Amsterdam at the ABN AMRO headquarters, they can go to Dutch Blockchain Conference?
Yeah, it's called big19.com or blockchaininnovationconference.com, or we'll have a link in the article. And if you want a discount from him, then he can give you a link to a discount. So then it's a couple of hundred euros. It's like 300 something euro, and including lunch and everything. And a great amount of people. If you don't have money, if you're far away, follow our HD video stream, because we're doing everything for free. But if you want to meet everybody and talk, then come in the Zuidas on June the 7th.
All right. Thank you very much, Vincent. All the best with your event, and nice to catch up again.